story. You're listening to Washington's Drive at 5 on 105.9 FM and AM 630 WMAL.
Confessions of a Closet Trump Supporter. Yeah, that's a headline that'll get you to click. Charlotte Laws wrote that headline, and she joins us right now. I saw the article, it made me laugh over at dailycaller.com, but it also got me thinking, Charlotte Laws. I think that, you know, a lot of people are suggesting that these polls right now that are showing support for Trump are understating the actual support because people are kind of shy about pronouncing their support. Is that the case that you've seen?
That's what I believe. Certainly, there are a lot of people who I've spoken with who do support him in a very secret manner. And it's true that you are called a racist, sexist, insane, stupid, every name in the book if you are a Trump supporter. So people are fearful to come out of the shadows.
By the way, I think this phenomenon is illustrated perfectly on Facebook. I think Facebook is a reflection of our society in so many ways, and this is one of them. I have, as you can well imagine, many conservatives and Republicans, people in the media who are Facebook friends, and when any of them make any kind of positive statement about Donald Trump, they are actually attacked by other conservatives, mm-hmm. by other Republicans. It's he's a very volatile figure right now. What do you make of that in terms of the people who are actually out there and as you said, coming out of the closet and proclaiming themselves?
Well, I do think that a lot of his support reflects this 42% of Americans who self-identify as independents.
Uh-huh.
And I think that a lot of people are extremely sick of both the Democratic Party and the Republican Party. And I know myself, I have been looking for an outsider or an independent candidate for decades. And it's so upsetting. Every time an election comes along, the two parties hijack the election. They put fear into the voters to say that you can't vote third party because the other guy will get elected. So people never really get to do what they want to do. They feel like they're manipulated.
Yeah.
And so this is the first election where a lot of us feel free. Like, finally, we can actually vote for somebody who's a breath of fresh air. And it's become, in a sense, not PC to be PC, which is kind of funny.
So Charlotte Laws is our guest. She's the author of the memoir Rebel in High Heels. And she's also been a Southern California politician and a weekly NBC pundit. And I want to, let me just, for the sake of argument, challenge you on a couple of things that people don't like about Donald Trump. And as an out-of-the-closet supporter, you can sort of push back. First of all, and this one I'll own myself. I won't do that journalist thing where say, some people believe. No, I believe this. I believe that if you're part of the Republican primary process and you're actually participating in the Republican debates and participating in the Republican balloting, you should commit to support whomever comes out of that process. I think he should do that. What's wrong with that position?
I think that, first of all, for example, when they had the Fox News debate and everybody was asked, would they pledge allegiance to the party, whoever the candidate might be? I mean, to me, that whole premise is so utterly disgusting. The idea that the Republican Party is daddy and I'm a child and I'm going to do whatever the party tells me to do. And also, you're committing to something. You don't even know the outcome. I mean, this is just an exercise, but let's assume, just for this example, that Hillary Clinton has an epiphany. And she realizes she's not a Democrat. She's suddenly a Republican. And she decides to run for the Republican primary. And lo and behold, miraculously, she is elected. You know, she becomes the candidate. All of those people on that stage in that debate have now committed to voting for Hillary Clinton.
All right. I mean, it's a bit of a far...
It's far-fetched,
maybe,
I know. But,
these days, maybe Kanye West is more likely. Yeah. I hear you. Okay, let me give you another one. He doesn't have the temperament to be president. Well, I hear this a lot. You know, it seems like half of the discussion about Donald Trump is not about what he intends to do and what his policies are. Half the discussion is, oh my gosh, I can't believe he said that. He's offended these people now. And the debate becomes about what he said and who he's offended instead of his actual policies.
Well, first of all, I don't think the reason why his poll numbers go up, even when he makes, you know, insults people, is because he kind of talks in this loose, playful way. And it's kind of, maybe it's a product of being the New Yorker saying, hey, you're a loser, let's have lunch tomorrow, you know, that kind of a thing, where people don't, it's really kind of playful. And someone even asked Trump, you know, what did you think of that whole, you know, dust up with Megyn Kelly? And he goes, oh, I thought it was kind of fun.
Yeah.
So in other words, he doesn't, you know, he doesn't take it seriously, and a lot of other people don't. As for his negotiating with foreign leaders and that kind of thing, he's really extremely likable, and he gets along with people very, very well. And I don't know him very well. I've met him on three occasions. And I can tell you that if you meet him, it's almost impossible not to like him. He is so likable, and he really loves people. And I do believe that he gets along with people. It doesn't matter if it's Putin or whoever it is. I think he is going to get along with these people. He gets along with Democrats and Republicans. He has a history of that.
All right, Charlotte Laws, she wrote Confessions of a Closet Trump Supporter. And are you starting a support group, a 12-step program? Are you, are you starting to, you know, get more people coming out of the closet on his behalf?
I'm trying. I've had a lot of secret emails from people who were thinking about it. They're still a little nervous.
Ah, the secret emails. I remember when I revealed myself to be conservative, I got all the secret emails. I can't say it either, but I'm with you. Go for it. All right, Charlotte Laws, thanks for joining us. As the campaign continues, we'll probably draw on your opinions in the future. Good to have you.
Thanks for having me on.
We will take your calls on this. Are you in the closet for Trump? And I want to hear your horror stories. If you've come out of the closet, how bad has it been for you? Give us a call, 888-630-WMAL.
It comes to talk.
Do you proudly wear a Make America Great baseball hat, but only inside the house? Do you secretly stare at that comb over in wonder and delight, not in horror? Do you play old episodes of Celebrity Apprentice over and over on a loop on your television just to get yourself ready for next year's presidential election? Are you a closeted Trump supporter? I want to hear from you. 888-630-9625. Give us a call and tell us your story. You know, I always thought I would do a program about coming out of the closet, but I never thought it would be like this. Trump fans, Trump supporters, it's time to come out of the closet. Be loud, be proud. You're here. You're... Well, we'll get used to it. Trump, why do Trump supporters have to be in the closet? That's the secondary question. Why do you have to be in the closet? 888-630-9625. This all comes from Charlotte Laws. We just spoke with her, a columnist over at the Daily Caller. She wrote this column, Confessions of a Closet Trump Supporter. Here's what sort of jumped out at me here. She said, talking about Trump supporters who were not in the closet, she says, weren't they worried about being called racist, sexist, insane, stupid, or even worse, Republican? It was as if they had turned into mini Trumps themselves, audacious, loud, and proud. They were a mere shell of their former selves, blubbering about hope, making America strong again, and ending illegal immigration. You know, that whole part, you know, weren't they worried about being called racist, sexist, insane, or stupid? Here's the thing. As a conservative Republican in the United States circa 2015, I take for granted that people are going to call me that, no matter who I'm supporting. Are you telling me that if you supported John Kasich, people wouldn't call you racist, sexist, insane, stupid, and, you know, all the other things? I mean, please, they called us that when we supported Mitt Romney, probably the nicest, most boring man on the planet. And they called us racist and hated women and all of those things. So, you know, I think that just is par for the course. But the difference with Trump, the real difference with Trump, is that at the same time the Huffington Post is calling you those things, well, the National Review could very well do the same thing. That's why people are a little hesitant of coming out. And I want to hear from you. 888-630-9625. Tell us your coming out story. By the way, for anybody who is in the closet and wants to come out, I want to play this for you because this illustrates exactly why people are embracing Donald Trump and also turns all of those arguments back on people who are supporting Hillary Clinton. How on earth are people proudly and openly supporting Hillary Clinton, for God's sake? Why aren't they in the closet? Why don't they have some sense of shame about supporting Hillary Clinton, considering what she is? And here's Donald Trump talking about Hillary Clinton and the entire disaster, the circus that's happening over in the Democratic Party, and by the way, was also happening in the State Department under Barack Obama. And this illustrates exactly why Trump is doing well.
When you look at what she's done and how she's done it, and the servers, and Uma. How about Uma? Now, okay, here's the story. So Uma now is one of the people that it all sort of came through Uma. Who is Uma married to? One of the great sleaze bags of our time. Anthony Weiner. Did you know that? She's married to Anthony Weiner. You know, the little bing, bing, bing. So Uma is getting classified secrets. She's married to Anthony Weiner, who's a perv. Oh, he is. He is.
So, all right, so this is why this is great. Not just because we just can't stand Anthony Weiner, and it always reminds me of that brilliant Andrew Breitbart press conference, the downfall of Anthony Weiner. But here's this is an obvious point that none of the establishment, you know, Jeb Bush is not going to make this point. John Kasich is not going to make this point. Scott Walker, God bless him, is not going to make this point. Even Ted Cruz won't make this point. Can anybody stand up and say, excuse me, Huma Abedin, the person a heartbeat away from the Secretary of State and possibly the President of the United States, is married to this sleazebag pervert who is the perfect prime target for blackmail? You don't think there are people out there with dirty little secrets about Anthony Weiner and she goes to bed every night with him and bore his child? Why on earth should she have security clearance when she's married to the most vulnerable man on the planet for blackmail purposes? And by the way, how about the judgment involved here of her not just marrying him in the first place, but staying with him through two of these public scandals? One that brought down his congressional career, the second that destroyed his mayoral campaign. She has no judgment at all. And by the way, what about Hillary Clinton's judgment for keeping her so close to her, despite the fact that she is obviously vulnerable to potential security breaches by being married to, I'll say it again, a sleazebag pervert? But no one else will make that argument. Donald Trump made the argument, and the man wants to be president. And that's kind of why I'm really liking him. All right, so it's time to come out of the closet. Sylvie in Waldorf, who heads up the Real Housewives of WMAL over on Facebook. If we're doing a coming out of the closet segment, we got to have you, Sylvie.
Thank you so much, Larry. You know, I am so in the closet here that I secretly hide from my husband to look on the TV every day to see if Trump is going to be giving a speech that night on any of the C-SPAN channels or CNN or MSNBC or whatever.
Wait, you're hiding this within your own home from your husband?
Yes.
Oh, this is bad.
I am, you know, I'm a Hispanic woman, so I got that, you know.
Oh, wait, you're supposed to hate him for the sexist and the xenophobic aspects.
I don't even want to confront my family about it because I'm afraid that I'll be disinherited, but we're forging on, and he tells it like it is. He doesn't read a teleprompter. He doesn't drink or smoke, and yes, he's short on the details, but so was Obama when he was running, and in fact, Obama is still short on the details 7 years into the presidency.
True, Sylvie, although I would argue, yes, Obama was short on the details, and how's that working out for us? So maybe we might want a little hope and change going the other direction. But Sylvie, thank you for the call. It's a great example. Yeah, I mean, can you imagine a Hispanic woman coming out of the closet in favor of Donald Trump? She will be attacked by everyone in her life. How about Michael in Sunshine, Maryland? Michael, you're on WMAL.
Hey, guys. Thanks for taking my call, Larry. I believe that I'm in the closet because there are too many people who care about how something is said as opposed to what is said. And my other point is that I believe he's really Teflon because he's just doesn't, there's not going to be cowed by political correctness.
And that's why you're liking him, but why does that lead you? I mean, you should be proclaiming it, Michael. I mean, are you on your Facebook page talking about it? Are you telling everybody about it?
Well, when people ask me who am I supporting, I say Donald Trump, and they get, you know, eyebrows raised.
Yeah.
And then I say, you know, he may use rhetoric that you don't like, but it's moral. How he says something.
Right.
You know, we have a president who says, you know, Hispanics should punish their enemies, and revenge is a good motive for voting.
Right.
That's pretty bad rhetoric there.
You're absolutely right, Michael. Thank you. And by the way, there are just as many Democrats who love Obama when he says stuff like that. That gets them fired up, but it gets us angered. So, it you know, the Trump-Obama comparison is actually pretty apt in terms of the passion and also the reluctance to proclaim your allegiance. The time is coming. in certain circles. All right, we'll continue with this Coming Out of the Closet special on Washington's Drive at 5. We want to hear all you closeted Trump supporters. It's safe. This is a safe zone for you. Come on out. It's 5:44. Here.
One of the great sleazebags of our time. Anthony Weiner. Did you know that? Who's a perv. Oh, he is. He is.
He is. The truth is the best defense, right? Right? He is. This is what you get with Donald Trump. You get great stuff like that, but there's so many reasons why people right now are sort of in the closet. Even though he's leading the poll, getting 30% in the national polls. He's got 23%, I think, in Iowa, which is, you know, enough to win with this kind of crowded field in Iowa. So imagine how many people are sort of secret out in there saying, you know, I gotta admit it, I kind of like Donald Trump. I mean, I know what the mainstream media is saying about him. I know what the left is saying about him. I know, you know, what even other Republicans are saying about him. But then I check him out talking about things like, well,
she's married to Anthony Weiner. You know, the little bing, bing, bing. So Uma is getting classified secrets. She's married to Anthony Weiner, who's a perv. Oh, he is. He is.
He is. All right, Joe in Southern, you're next up on WMAL. Hey, Joe.
Hey, Larry. I was reminded of the fact that every person who's making a comment negatively about Trump, I'm taking names and holding grudges against every single one of these lousy commentators, including the ones on Fox.
Really? You're saying that you're going to hold on to this hatred and anger through the 8 years of the presidency of Donald Trump?
Oh, sure. Absolutely.
Well, listen, I have no horse in this race at this point. I am not back anyway. But there are a couple of criticisms of Donald Trump that are somewhat legitimate. Wouldn't you agree?
Possibly, but to be totally negative about Trump at this time, 16 months ahead of fact, is foolish. It just shows people's stupidity.
Well, however,
and their biases.
But Joe, right now the Republican Party is going through a process of choosing who's going to represent them in a very important election. So now is a good time to scrutinize these guys. So let me just challenge you, Joe, because you're out of the closet. You're out there. You're ready. You're taking names of people who don't agree. So here's my challenge. How do you explain all of this past positions, his past support of the Clintons, his support of the Democratic Party, his sort of bouncing back and forth from Republican to Democrat?
Easy. Trump said it himself. Ronald Reagan was a Democrat before he became a Republican.
Well, Ronald Reagan would say that the Democratic Party left him. He didn't leave the Democratic Party.
Really?
But really, I mean, it's not like he changed all the time. I mean, he still believed what he believed the entire time. Donald Trump has actually changed his position. Ronald Reagan didn't really change his position except for one thing that I'm aware of, and that was abortion.
You're true about that, but, you know, even Churchill had the expression, if you're not a liberal when you're young, you're foolish. If you're not a conservative when you're older, you don't have any heart.
All right.
And I agree with that 100%.
All right, Joe, thanks for calling. I hear you. How about Jim in Falls Church? You're next up on WMAL. Jim, are you in the closet for Trump?
Yeah, no, I'm coming out. I just was telling your screener, Trump has just in the last 2 or 3 weeks come out with a beautiful second website, a new presidential website, and he has a beautiful line of products on there, all proudly made in America. He was bragging about it in Mobile, his speech he gave in Mobile, wearing the hat. He calls them a hat, but it's really a cap.
Yeah.
He has 12 different varieties of caps. They're each $25. They're all proudly made in the USA.
So you're gonna come out of the closet fully adorned in your Trump paraphernalia that you purchased from his website.
Well, I've just purchased a couple of versions of bumper stickers that he has and window clings, which I've never used a window cling before, but for the car. I think we need to get these on our car. That's how Obama did it. You know, he sent everybody a free bumper sticker.
They did. They got. They had hope out there, Jim. All right. Thanks for coming out today. How about Bill in Sterling? Oh, no, that was Bill. Bill in Sterling. You're next up on WMAL. Hey, Bill.
Hey, guys. How you doing? Great show today, man. I'm loving this.
Thanks.
Hey, I was for Trump before he even announced that he was for Trump.
But were you open? Were you out there, or were you in the closet?
Well, every time I would say I wish Trump would run, they'd say, you're crazy. He's never going to get in the race. I'd say, well, I sure wish he would. And when he came out and announced it, my heart soared like an eagle. I have so many things in common with Mr. Trump.
Like what?
Did I share them with you?
Yeah, but please, quickly, though. We're almost out of time.
Yeah, we're the exact same age, okay?
All
He's
right.
a businessman, self-employed over 40 years. so am I.
Yeah.
He likes nice things, I like nice things. His son went to Georgetown at the exact same time that my son went to Georgetown. He has a lot of money, I want a lot of money. He hates and despises, makes fun of politicians, I do too. We just have so many things in common. The guy doesn't BS around.
All right, Bill, welcome out of the closet. Enjoy it. Live it, own it, parade around. What we need is a Trump Pride Day is what we need. I'll warm up the crowd. I'm not going to march, but I'll show up and watch.